He couldn't cause for the Lord to suffer there in the hell, so like that. Should read, and then you know the medicine Buddha, how it's so important in the life. You must practice every day life medicine Buddha, then you really know how it makes everything so easy that you think it difficult, makes so easy. Or even whatever you think makes so difficult, or makes so easy. Not practice medicine Buddha. So the some heavy sickness or something or big project. There's a fifth Dalai Lama has extensive medicine Buddha puja. That's unbelievable. We translated a long time, many years ago. The student in America, the husband, but he didn't translate for only a year, left out. And then his wife translated Beth or something. What's her name? Beth? What? Yeah, but she translated extensive medicine Buddha practice written by Pipta Dalai Lama. So in Tibet, were great success for hundreds of years Buddhism in Tibet. So much success. They study and whole intra. Whole India, Theravada, and the Paramedaya, Namaya, Dandra, all that taught by Buddha are completely studied and actualized the path. And so many Buddhas, happened in Tibet. So much happened due to medicine Buddha practice. Pipta Dalai Lama wrote this extensive, and so because there's so much happened in India. Also, Mongolia, the Sajja Pandit and Gamapaksha and Sikin Karmapa and few lamas were invited in Mongolia and Dharma studied. And then seven Dalai Lama was invited. Seven Dalai Lama. Maybe people are unsure. So much Buddhism in Mongolia spread so much. How many hundreds of top learned geshes, learned geshes. Happened in Mongolia, now they're all dead. Russia took over, the communists took over them. More than 50 years, I don't know. Then they went back and so now the Buddhism revived back again in Mongolia, so happened in. So anyway, all that unbelievable during medicine Buddha practice spread. They become major practice. The Pamanga, the Jinning Bo, the Hiruka, in Latin being Hiruka, mentioned in degenerate and difficult time like now, degenerate time, the Medicine Pam Sutra as a Medicine Buddha whom you pray, whom you rely on. So the Medicine Buddha's power is increasing and not degenerating. So the, for example, mantras now need more. Before 100,000 is okay for action, for action, enable action retreat. 100,000 okay. Now the 400,000 is all. So now the power is going down. So you have to start more mantras. But the minister said, the more time gets, and now medicine Buddha's power is more powerful. From Sutra, from Tantra, Hiruga deity is then the more powerful. Yes, that time we got the more degenerated. So therefore, it's something, you know, your life is something, no, I don't have time too much to say, life is something so much difficult. All that, then if you want to make it easy, all the practice medicine, but that's my conclusion, my answer. You want to raise symbol, all practice medicine Buddha. All the medicine Buddha, for yourself or for others, dead, sick, living, or for any problem, so you're going to do medicine Buddha Puja, for any problem, like that. So there's any problem, or you don't know, like if you don't know how to check or how to do observation like that, they just do medicine Buddha Puja, that covers everything for dead, for people dead, for living family members. You want to benefit, you want to help somebody dead, you want to help even for yourself, for others. So that medicine Buddha. There's Pitti Dalamas, most expensive, unbelievable, powerful. And you can see when you have some important project or something, or heavy sicknesses or something, or you want to help somebody died or that. But it's Pitti Dalamas, they're very expensive in English. Then there's short one. Composed by Gajin Yishi Jiaozhen, Great Lama there. Then that was English, translated by somebody in American, that translated somebody for many years ago. This is what the most centers, what they do practice. Recently, Buddhaya, they practiced the Jalamas. They did that practice in English. And so the people really enjoy so much. So like that, this is great. All like that. All like that. I said that, I think I mentioned yesterday, I don't know, mosquitoes and crabs, frogs and the crabs, mosquitoes, even they should reside. Medicine Buddha prayer, even the frogs, wow, you know, medicine Buddha mantra, they should reside in the frogs, mosquitoes, all those, you know, the black one, the in Adelaide, when we did the black animal. We picked so many in the house, in the road, and went down to Buddha relics for them to each have enlightenment. And then I blessed water, then pour on them. And I didn't know, so pour two times. And it seems like they're suffering so much with the water. So later I found out you can't put water to them, blessed water. So I learned afterwards, but two times I made a mistake. So I don't know what it's called. What it's called?
Millipede.
Yes, the millipede should reside. Omani Pemi Hung and Medicine Buddha. If they want happiness. But they can't. They don't have human body, they can't. They don't have karma. They don't have human body. Can't reside. They don't karma, they don't him about it. But we have karma. So must reside. Medicine Buddha, among them must. If you want happiness, if you don't want happiness, okay. If you want only suffering, it's okay. But if you want happiness, yes. That's my short explanation. So, especially those who are doing healing, massage, healing, anything, other. I mean, generally, but especially people who are doing healing, healing or I mean, the doctor, I mean, just involved in the, treating people, things, or must do Medicine Buddha, or that the gifts, or that you pray to Medicine Buddha, or gives so much power, gives so much possibility to cure. You pray, if you rely on Medicine Buddha, if you rely on Medicine Buddha, 100%, oh, so much. So the, in Taiwan, there was one person, he's not Buddhist, I don't know his name, was sick. I don't know, maybe cancer. So the doctor, many people, yeah, you might know, he's from Austria, the one of the oldest sanghas. Dr. Edin was older than you, and so he was not the original sangha, but he was much later. But somebody who still stayed as a monk, still stayed as a monk. So for many years, he did 3 years retreat in where? Kangaroo Island. Yeah, he did 3 years retreat. So now there live Bendigo, the monastery there, Shivling, so recently burnt. I think Sam Sherpa's family came to light in the marina, to light candles inside. So they left, the Mongols left, one monk. There's and then it seems they burned the Gomba, something like that. Now they're reporting. Anyway, so he filled up a Medicine Buddha statue, small. He filled up the mantra. So what happened was Medicine Buddha next table. You know, he was laying down. So at his table, there's a Medicine Buddha statue. So he needed medicine from the bathroom. Medicine was in the bathroom. So he had nobody to get the medicine from the bathroom. So what happened was, he slowly looked at the Medicine Buddha statue. The Medicine Buddha statue was holding medicine in the right hand. The medicine he had in the bathroom was a Medicine Buddha was holding in the right hand. The statue, the small statue, filled by Gato. So then he was able to take the medicine. Then when he died with the hand like this. I'm sure praying in Medicine Buddha. While he was protesting at the heart like this, he died. So he died with the devotion. The Medicine Buddha. So I'm sure that's positive rebirth at the Pure Land or the higher birth to meet Dharma again. So then Krishna Geshe Lama Gunto gave Medicine Buddha picture to somebody who is in a coma. So Geshe Lama Gunto gave Medicine Buddha picture, put it on the bed, above the bed. So here's a pillow, the patient's laying down here. So here Medicine Buddha put that, and the patients got better. Woke up from the coma. So that happened. There's I'm sure there's amazing things. So if you completely rely on medicine Buddha, so that's so. Then in Hong Kong, the co-director of the our center in Hong Kong, Kaza, what's the name? No, name of the center. Name of the center. Huh? Oh, Cham Zeling. Name of the center. So, co-director, the resident teacher is my relative, Bemba. So, co-director who worked on finance and both the center and all the development, so Esther. So she had big operation of her brain head. So she been sick almost all the time, headache all the time, then sometimes worse, all the time. So she had big operation, the brain. Very big operation. So during that time, she see Medicine Buddha. She see during that time, what big operation happened, she see Medicine Buddha. Normally, she recite just one mala, nothing much, just one mala, recite Medicine Buddha mantra. So I think during that, so during the operation, big operation, she see Medicine Buddha. Oh, during that time. So the saved by saved her. That's unbelievable. I mean, the Blessed Buddha during that time, can you imagine? It's unbelievable. So that, right now, because you know, Blessed Buddha know I'm talking. Medicine Buddha knows you are listening. You are taking Medicine Buddha Janan. That is right now. Medicine Buddha is not just picture or statue. So anyway, so if you recite one time the Medicine Buddha mantra, then that's like reciting all the Buddha's holy name. If you recite Medicine Buddha mantra one time, then recite all the Buddha's mantra, numberless Buddha's mantra, name and mantra. If you make offering, if you prostrate to Medicine Buddha, like prostrating to all the Buddhas. If you make offering to Medicine Buddha, then make prayer is like the same to all the Buddhas. Recite mantra or remember Medicine Buddha, seeing Medicine Buddha, seeing Medicine Buddha statue picture, hearing about Medicine Buddha, touching Medicine Buddha, meditating on Medicine Buddha. So the same with all the Buddhas that you did this, you get the benefit. This Buddha's holy name is called Deshakundiki Chen. So all the embodied all the Buddha's holy name. The mantra is all the Buddha's holy mantra, or embodied all the Buddha's the mantra. Then that makes successful all your temporary and ultimate work and wishes and purpose. All the temporary ultimate wishes and purpose, or you easily get a success. So as I told before, then you destroy the purify the 10 non-virtues, and all the negative karmas get purified. And then as soon as you die, and you get born. It says here, then you get born Buddha's pure land, and Buddha's Pure Land, and then you you see, achieve full enlightenment after so easily. So don't then by reciting medicine Buddha name and mantra one time, there is a long mantra and short mantra and very short mantra. So if you recite a mantra one time, it purifies 80,000 eons, not years, not days, not lifetimes, eons, 80,000 eons of the karma get purified. So keep this in mind. Don't forget. If you recite 10 times medicine with the mantra, 800,000 negative karma, 800 eons of negative karma get purified. If you recite 20 times, 10 million. 8 times of 10 million negative karma get pure. 10 million eons. 8 times of 10 million eons of negative karma get purified. If you recite one mala, then you purify negative karma's quality from beginningless rebirth. By just hearing medicine Buddha, remembering medicine Buddha, it purifies stamina. Stamina is the kill father, mother, this life, and arahata, cause blood Buddha, and cause disin Ramana Sangha. So if you commit the end of this negative karma, then so heavy, so when you die, delays other negative karmas, lighter ones, you delay for many long time, eons, wasn't a long time. And then you get immediately, you get reborn in the lost hotel, Nyawanamne. Hot hell, the eighth one, last one. They last for one intermediate eon. The English karma, the length of life is one intermediate eon, and is the heaviest suffering, and your body is like one is fire, or one is with fire, like firewood, the logwood, one is fire, or red. Except the screaming sound, then you can see this sentiment, otherwise you can't recognize the sentiment. So the unbelievable, by seeing, touching, and all that, purifies the negative karma, 10 number virtues, by touching and the seeing and remembering this Buddha's holy body, holy picture, purifies the pollution of the Sangha. So when you live in a monastery, so if you don't practice Dharma, if you become lazy, you don't practice Dharma, purification, collective merit, all the things what you're supposed to don't do, being lazy, then people offer food or things with the devotion to the Sangha, then it becomes pollution. Then difficult to have realization, to learn Dharma, so things like that. So they can purify. And of course, this is Ramana Sangha. Then when you are manager, the offerings of the Sanghas, you stopped, or you criticize the Sanghas, or all those things, Ramas get purified. If you make offering to meditation Buddha, you criticize the Lama Guru, broke the advice, harmed the Buddha Guru's holy body, broke the advice to disturb the holy mind, so misuse the Guru's things, so all those get purified. So I stop here. The unbelievable, the benefits so much, so this book must get it, and read, and you will enjoy it so much. So then inspired to practice. So makes everything difficult, easy. How about that? So basically, of course, to benefit the other sentient beings, to free the sentient beings from ocean, bring the enlightenment. Oh, that's the main reason, main thing. Okay, that's all. Then ad esempio su there's a very short one. I translated long time ago at the Kapan in the Kapan Monastery, Altar Monastery, with the Gato. I translated short one. There's a healing one from Prama Sambhava. Not, I'm not talking that one. People use more that one. I'm not talking that one. There's a short one. Brevity, the what Thunder Centers do in English, that one, and the extensive, the people down, the condensed, the short practice. There's book, blue, black book, a short, I translated with Yasuo. That one, if you can practice, so good. It's unbelievable, it's short, that's very rich. I didn't see, I see the healing one with Lord, but that one I didn't see much. People don't understand, so. I'm not saying everybody, but I'm saying general people. Seems not even that book you don't see much. So the okay. So if you so essence is several before that to the medicine Buddha. Practice, you should not do that. The reciting each name seven times. It comes here with the initiation. You're reciting each name seven times, and the reciting of one mala mantra, all that. So like that. That's the main thing. Then I'm doing the Gato to Dharma to the interferers who receive grand initiation, to interfere for that. Not only that, normally, as I remember, then I do for any sentient who needs the Gato. So that's, I try to do like that, try to think like that. So become puja for everybody, anybody who needs. So,